Welcome. The Office of the Chief Data Officer and the Texas Department of Information Resources are proud to offer this course on Data Visualization Design Basics. In this course, we will discuss four principles of design relevant to the development of data visualizations: proximity, alignment, repetition, and contrast. Effective presentation of data is at the core of an organization's ability to meaningfully extract insights that will support the strategic mission and goals. Raw data in and of itself is often meaningless. Data needs interpretation and context to explain its importance and communicate key messages before it can become actionable information. Data visualization is the graphical representation of data and information using visuals, such as tables, charts, and graphs, to highlight patterns and trends. It provides an effective way to summarize thousands of columns and rows of data and present it in an understandable format. Conversations with your customers before you begin your analysis will help you understand the full context of their questions, how they need to consume or interact with the data, and what they plan to do with the information next. These conversations will help you design data visualizations that are most appropriate for the questions at hand. Additionally, applying a few design principles will help you develop visualizations that are organized, uncluttered, and highlight the most important information. Information design is the practice of presenting information in a clear and accessible way to help people process that information quickly and accurately. Design principles are important for website or graphic design, but they also apply to the development of data visualizations. Applying design principles in the development of your data visualizations allows you to present data and analyses in a way that clearly reveals what the data means and help users quickly understand the information. This course is not intended to provide complete detail about every principle of a design. However, we will introduce four principles that are particularly relevant to the design of your data visualizations. Regardless of whether you use tables, charts and graphs, or maps to present your data and analysis, applying these four design principles in the development of your data visualizations is essential to ensure your data story is conveyed clearly and concisely, and to reduce the risk of misinterpretation. One of those principles is proximity. The Gestalt Law of Proximity states that individual objects placed close to each other are perceived as belonging together. The principle of proximity refers to the practice of grouping related items together so they become part of one visual unit, and placing unrelated items further apart. Proximity is one technique to use when you want your audience to quickly understand what information in your visualizations are related. As an example, even though the blue ovals on the screen are all the same, the arrangement of the ovals gives the sense of two separate groups and indicates the ovals within each group are related in some way. Even if there are differences within the groups, the placement of the shapes indicates a relationship within each group and a difference between the groups. When creating tables, graphs, or dashboards, place related elements close together. This allows your audience to quickly identify meaningful clusters and better understand the elements are related. Be careful of grouping related elements too close together, however, as it may be difficult for your audience to tell they are separate visual elements if there isn't enough white space between them. Proximity is also important in the design of data tables. Choose your column order so that data points you want to compare are close to each other. In this table, the column for actual makes more sense to be to the left of the column for target. By placing the actual column closer to the target column, your audience can quickly see the difference between them, and the other columns are easier to interpret and therefore more meaningful. Another relevant principle of design is alignment. Alignment isn't just about using left or right alignment of graphs, text, and numbers, but also refers to how elements in your data visualizations align with other elements to indicate a relationship between them. Many people tend to read left to right and top to bottom, So consider positioning the information on your dashboards in this order as well. Place the most important information in the top left corner of the page, with supporting or less important information placed toward the bottom right corner of the page. Alignment of elements in your dashboard can simplify where your audience has to look and guide them to read the information in a structured or prescribed order. Therefore, consider the various aspects of the report or dashboard you are developing and think of those elements as parts of a whole. Use the principle of alignment to guide your audience to look at that most important element first, and then lead them to the next element of your story, and so on. Alignment creates a sense of order and unity on the page. When you place each element in your visualization or dashboard, align it with other related elements. For example, align graphs and accompanying text with each other, so it is obvious they go together. Consistency in the position and alignment of elements in your visualizations is key to helping your audience navigate the dashboard and interpret the data. Elements such as title, legends, and clickable buttons should always be in the same place within each visual. Alignment is also important in the design of data tables to make them look professional and easy to read and understand. Numbers should be aligned to the right, and the number of decimal points, if any, should be consistent to allow the numbers to align properly. Text and dates should be aligned to the left. Centering data in your columns is appropriate if your column heading is long and the text within the table cells is the same length. However, centering is generally discouraged as it forces your audience to work harder to find the beginning of each line, especially for those with visual impairments or dyslexia, and increases the amount of time it takes to understand the information and for an actionable decision to be made. A third principle of design relevant to data visualization is repetition. Repetition is the practice of repeating similar visual elements throughout your report or dashboard to create themes and highlight similarities. Human brains love patterns, and repetition unifies and connects what may appear to be disparate elements of the visualizations but are in fact related. Consistent repetition creates familiarity and helps your audience locate relevant information quickly. Representing the same thing in different ways causes confusion for your audience. Repetition reduces confusion and leads to quicker insights. Aspects of repetition can be found in the proximity and alignment principles. However, repetition may also be achieved by the consistent use of colors, shapes and sizes, lines, graphic elements, textures, or fonts to represent the same thing across your charts and graphs. For example, if Travis County is represented by the color yellow in one graph, it should be represented with yellow in all graphs where it appears on your dashboard. If you present significant data points in bright blue in one visualization, use that same style for presenting significant data points in all your visualizations in your dashboard. If you use a bar or column chart to represent expenditures in one instance, all visualizations representing expenditures should also be in the form of a bar or column chart if possible. Repetition is important in table design as well. Consistent use of colors, textures, fonts, sizes, and lines helps your audience locate and understand relevant information quickly. Within a table, you can also use the same style of alternating, repeating fill on every other row of long tables to improve readability. The fourth principle of design particularly relevant to data visualization is contrast. While repetition is used to highlight similarities, contrast highlights differences in the data. You can create contrast in your visualizations through the use of color, shape, size, texture, and lines. Color can be an important part of your data visualization design. Color can be used to distinguish groups or categories from each other, represent data values, or to highlight specific elements in the data. When using color to distinguish groups, choose high contrasting colors that are clearly distinct from each other and do not create a sense of order or ranking. When using color to represent data values that may have order or ranking, you can use darker colors to represent larger numbers and lighter colors to represent smaller numbers. However, be careful with using gradients of color that may create a sense of order or ranking where it is not appropriate, or with using colors that are too similar, as those may be difficult to distinguish for people with visual impairments. Use color combinations that provide a high degree of color contrast. To highlight specific elements in the data, select colors that vividly stand out from the other colors in your visualization. You should consider the colors you use to avoid issues for people with color vision deficiency or other visual impairments. For example, many people with color blindness have difficulty distinguishing between red and green. There are many tools available for checking color and contrast requirements, such as the Adobe Color Contrast Checker or the WebAIM Contrast Checker, as well as colorblind simulators you can use to test your visualizations for accessibility requirements. Consult with the accessibility coordinator in your organization, if you have one, for assistance with choosing your color palette to make sure your visualizations meet accessibility requirements. Color isn't the only way to provide contrast to distinguish key data points. Shape and size differences can also provide contrast to highlight differences in the data and help the most important information stand out. Alternatively, you can use various textures within your visualization to provide contrast in your graphs. Elements within your visualization must be visually distinguishable by containing unique shapes, patterns, or markings, and the key or legend must indicate what each style means. You can also use various widths or patterns in the lines displayed in a line graph to provide contrast. This is especially helpful when you have overlapping lines over time, or you have limits on the number of high contrasting colors you can use. Use varying line widths and types that are easily distinguishable from each other to avoid confusion. Line graphs are best when there are a limited number of categories or groups in the data. If the lines in your graph are not easily distinguishable from each other due to a large number of categories, consider choosing a different type of visualization to present the information. Effective presentation of data is at the core of an organization's ability to meaningfully extract insights that will support the strategic mission and goals. The four design principles we have discussed here are foundational to the development and presentation of good data visualizations, no matter what format of visualization you use. Data visualizations should be designed with the use case in mind, so it is important to talk with your customers to make sure you understand the full context of what they need before you begin your analysis and develop the visualizations. Know who your audience is and how they will consume or interact with the visualization, as well as what they plan to do with the information next. These things will serve as a starting point for developing your data visualizations. Finally, as a good practice, consult with the accessibility coordinator in your organization, if you have one, to make sure your data visualizations meet accessibility requirements. For more information on accessibility tools and resources, visit the Texas Department of Information Resources website. You have now completed the course on Data Visualization Design Basics. In this course, we talked about four principles of design relevant to data visualization: proximity, alignment, repetition, and contrast. For more information on the Texas Statewide Data Program, visit the Office of the Chief Data Officer website.